The DNS protocol is one of the most important protocols of the internet. In a nutshell, it translates a website's domain name, like google.com, into an IP address that your computer needs to reach the site. Without it, we would need to memorize the IP addresses of each site we want to visit. Not very convenient. You can learn more about DNS in one of my previous videos. In this video, however, I want to zoom in on two privacy issues with DNS. First, the protocol does not use encryption. Every time your computer needs to know an IP address, it asks a DNS resolver, but these requests can be intercepted, allowing others to see the sites you visit. This data could also be used to identify which devices you have in your home. A smart thermostat, for instance, might communicate with a specific domain name. An attacker that intercepts your DNS requests can see this and then use that knowledge to exploit a weakness in the device, possibly exposing your entire network. This problem, however, is easy to solve. Encrypt the connection between you and the DNS resolver with HTTPS. That is the same technology that puts a green padlock in your browser. Adding encryption means that nobody can intercept your DNS requests and keep track of the sites you visit. This technique is called DNS over HTTPS, or DOH for short. So problem one is fixed, but the second problem is more fundamental. The DNS resolver you use will always be able to see who you are based on your IP address and what sites you visit based on the DNS requests you make. These resolvers are usually hosted by internet service providers, and some of these go as far as selling your browser history to third parties. What's more, governments can use DNS to monitor citizens and even block content on the internet. Not cool at all. To fix this problem, developers from Cloudflare, Apple, and Fastly work together to create Oblivious DNS, or ODNS for short. And the idea is rather simple. Introduce an intermediary that can only see who you are, but not the sites you visit. Here's how it works. On one end, you have the ODNS resolver, a server somewhere on the internet that is capable of translating domain names into IP addresses. On the other end, you have your device that wants to know the IP address of a given website. And in between is a proxy server that protects your privacy. Now imagine you want to visit google.com. Your computer will create a DNS request and encrypt it so that only the ODNS resolver can read it. Something you can do with asymmetric encryption, which you can learn more about in this video here. Anyway, this encrypted message is then sent to the proxy server, which can see your IP address, but because of the encryption, can't see your DNS request. All it does is forward your request to an ODNS resolver. This one does have the ability to decrypt your message and see what site you want to visit. However, it doesn't know who actually sent the request, because the proxy server is in between. This is great for privacy. The ODNS resolver then looks up the IP address, encrypts the response so that only you can read it, sends it back to the proxy, which relays it back to you. And that's it. The proxy server in the middle shields your IP address from resolvers that actually handle your request. So in summary, the proxy server can see who you are, but not the sites you visit. And the ODNS resolver can see the sites you visit, but not who you are. This means that your privacy is protected as long as the proxy and the ODNS resolver are run by separate organizations that don't share data with one another. If these two would work together, they could link your IP address from the proxy server to the DNS request in the ODNS resolver. ODNS is, without a doubt, a great addition to protect our online privacy. But does it have a bad influence on our browsing experience? Surely these extra steps must slow everything down, right? Well, kind of. The team that developed ODNS ran some benchmarks and they concluded that yes, there is a performance penalty, but it's not significant. The encryption adds a delay of around 2 milliseconds, and there's also some extra time needed because your request has to go through a proxy before hitting the resolver. But it should not be noticeable while browsing the web. So there you go, that is how ODNS could protect your online privacy. Right now, it's not supported by any operating system, but Cloudflare has published an open source implementation that can be tested today. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe if you found this video interesting, and I'll see you in the next one.